So on behalf of BN College family, I am Sushmita. Welcome you all in this online program organized by Internal Quality Assurance Cell, BN College, Dhubri, Assam. Am I audible, Sujit?
You are audible, but your video is off. Video.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Now
yes.
It is okay. Okay. So I welcome you all in this online program. Now let us start this evening by chanting Sangyana Suktam from Rig Veda. I request Dr. Moushami Bhattacharji, HOD, Department of Sanskrit, BN College, to recite that. Over to you, Dr. Bhattacharji.
Thank you, Sushmita. Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am, please.
Sarvibha Sarvaibhascha Namo Namaha. Rig Veda is a संज्ञान सूक्तस्य मंत्रोच्चारणेन भोलानाथ महाविद्यालयस्य विवेकानंद शिक्षण केन्द्र उद्घाटन उपलक्षे आयोजित वक्तृतानुष्ठानस्य शुभारंभः क्रियते. लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन एंड माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, लेट अस हैव एन ऑस्पिशियस बिगिनिंग ऑफ दिस वेबिनार. संगच्छध्वं संवदध्वं संगवो मनां सिजानतम् देवाभागं यथा पूर्वे संजानना उपासते समानो मंत्र समिति ही समानी समानं मन सहचित्तमे शाम संगच्छध्वं संवदध्वं संगो मनां सिजानतम् समानीव आकुति समाना हृदयानीव समानमस्तु वो मनो यथाव सुसहासति संगच्छध्वं संवदध्वं संगवो मनां सिजानतम् 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 धन्यवाद. थैंक यू
डॉक्टर भट्टाचार्जी. Now I would like to invite Dr. Dhruva Chakravarti, Honorable Principal of our college, to address this August gathering. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, Sushmita. Namaste. First of all, a very good afternoon to all. I, on behalf of BN College Dhubri, welcome all in this webinar associated with inauguration of Vivekananda Study Center of this college and inaugural lecture of the lecture series on man-making and nation building organized by BN College Dhubri in collaboration with Vivekananda Kendra. BN College has established a memorandum of understanding with Vivekananda Kendra to work together and spread the philosophy of Swami Vivekananda to strengthen the spirit of self-reliance and universal brotherhood through education. This program is a step in that direction. We will put our efforts to organize seminar workshop, personality development camps, etc., initiate research activities, group study to understand Swamiji's vision. We have already organized one quiz competition among the class representatives of our college on life and philosophy of Swamiji. In the next step, the class representatives will organize similar quiz competitions among the students of their classes. The idea is to reach as many students as possible. We have established Vivekananda Corner in our college library, where various books on Swamiji are kept together so that users can easily locate the books. The Vivekananda Study Center that is going to be inaugurated today will be attached with the Department of Philosophy of our college, which will look after the day-to-day activities of the study center. Srimati Navanita Devi, Associate Professor of the Department of Philosophy, will act as coordinator of the study center. I believe the study center will go a long way in helping the student community to understand Swamiji and ignite their mind for selfless service and love for the nation. Our activities must be a step forward to actualize Swamiji's dream of making Jagat Guru Bharat. We are extremely honored and grateful to Padma Shri Honorable Nivedita Vireji for agreeing to act as resource person and also to inaugurate the Vivekananda Study Center. Welcome you, Didi, in this program. We are also grateful to all the office bearers and workers of Vivekananda Kendra, particularly Praveen Ji, who is instrumental in establishing the MOU with this college. We are grateful to Dr. Vivas Das Purukasta Sir, former principal Pandu College, and Sangrakshak Bharatiya Shikshan Mandal for agreeing to inaugurate this webinar. We extend our sincere thanks to all the distinguished personalities who have joined this webinar on our invitation. Sincere thanks to students and teachers of this college. I believe it will be an extremely enriching experience for all of us. Welcoming all of you once again, I would like to conclude. Thank you. Over to Susmita.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Respected participants, Swami Vivekananda says that education is the manifestations of the perfection already in man. And I believe that teachers and gurus are the person to help us to reach that. Today, I am very happy to have my teacher, my guru, Dr. Vibhas Chandra Das Purukasta Sir with us. Although Sir needs no introduction, but it is my privilege to introduce him with you all. Dr. Vibhas Chandra Das Purukasta is retired as principal Pandu College, Guwahati. He is a former governor of Rotary. Sir has been awarded with most prestigious Rotary Award, the Vocational Service Leadership Award for his contribution in education and literacy in the year 2016. He is also a court member of Boroland University. Sir is one of the Sangrakshak of Bharatiya Shikshan Mandal. Sir, may I now request you to kindly inaugurate this auspicious occasion and kindly speak a few words for us. Over to you, sir.
Namaskar. Honorable Principal Dr. Dhruva Chakravarti, revered Nivedita Didi, the chief guest, the inaugurator of Vivekananda Corner, the keynote speaker. IQSA team of DN College, led by Dr. Susmita Sengupta, my dear students, faculty members, and distinguished guests, Namaskar. এনে সুযোগ সকলে নেপায়। আই মাস্ট এডমিট দ্যাট আই এম ফেভার্ড এন্ড ফর্চুনেট টু ইনগ্রেট এন ইনোভেটিভ প্রোগ্রাম, এ মান্থলি লেকচার বাই এ গেস্ট স্পিকার ফ্রম অ্যাক্রস দ্য কান্ট্রি এন্ড বিয়ন্ড। I'm amazed to find the tagline of this program is kept as man making and nation building, an objective put forward by Swami Vivekananda for education, that education should have the sole purpose of man making and nation building, reminding us that even in higher education this has relevance. No college in the Northeast, so far I know, has a program of this type. And I wish this endeavor becomes a trendsetter. I express my gratitude to the college authority for associating me in this novel effort. Any activity, according to our tradition, is initiated by lighting a lamp, followed by a chanting prayer. Of course, a prayer Sangat Chaddam was sung, chanted earlier. In a virtual platform, I'm not sure as how this can be done. Now let us imagine that lamp is lighted to dispel the darkness of ignorance, and I pray, শুভম করতু কল্যাণম আরোগ্যম শত সম্পদম শত্রুবুদ্ধি বিনাশয় দীপজ্যোতি নমস্তুতে। I'm doubly fortunate, in fact, doubly fortunate, because Sadhya Nivedita Didi is going to deliver today on a topic which is close to her heart, for which she has dedicated her life also. So it will be definitely an experience to remember. A little bit about going away from whole of the thing. Recently, I have gone through a research paper by Michael Fullan and Joan Quinn, in collaboration with Microsoft. In fact, it was it is a position paper on a paradigm shift of education from remote to hybrid learning. It was published in July 2020 in the backdrop of COVID-19 and titled Education Reimagined: The Future of Learning. It is a heavy work is done about the paper. I have gone through, there are 35 pages. Recently I have downloaded and gone through it. What has attracted me, that nearly at the end of this, end of the paper, they have analyzed, surveyed, and suggested, and ultimately they have suggested a profile for deep learning. Learning is a problem. Suggested 6 global competencies to flourish learner as citizen of the world. 6 global competencies to flourish learners as citizens of the world. The 6 global competencies they have identified are basically 6 C's. Soita C ase tat. First one is character. Second one is citizenship. Third one is collaboration. Fourth, communication. Fifth, creativity. And sixth is critical thinking. Now look at the thing, the first two. What are first two? Character and citizenship. Are they not matching with what Vivekananda said much earlier, man making and nation building. So this is a coincidence, but West is coming because they were not giving much emphasis on character. Whenever you go for learning the materialistic world, character to them was not much important. But here in this research paper, I seen that character was number one and citizenship was number two. So the tagline that BN College has adopted for this series of lectures is completely matching with this one. So that is why I wanted to share with you this thing. They have also suggested that this deep learning of competences in digital mode, they suggested certain media, how they can be learned. So they say it can be learned through partnership, maintaining proper learning to proper environment. And of course, leveraging digital, because it will be a hybrid mode. So digital leveraging is necessary and pedagogical practices would be needed. So these are the facts from this research. It has come or derived, you can say. My intention is that the target group for which this project is organized, I point out basically teachers and faculty members, should undergo at least a session of internalization of each of the lecture by way of discussion, analysis, and thinking for implementation. They have to be aware of the fact that this project is not for ornamentation of the college, nor it is for increasing its profile. Somebody may think, yes, they have arranged it for this thing. But this was done because after consultation, I have gone through the IQAC coordinator. She was saying, I'm sincere to my effort. I want that our students be of good citizen and how they can become. And that is why this program is taken. So I wish all success of the project, let it survive and sustain and serve the intended objective for which it was launched. I conclude with a Dheva Sloka of Bharatiya Shikshan Mandal, jisme bolte hai, tat karma janmandha jo ja navandhaya sha vidyaya vimukte aya shaya aparang karma vidyayanna shilpanipannam. Ji karmat bandhan nai, jod bandhan nai, hetuye karma, aru jitue mukti diye, hetuye vidya. Baki hokolo karma, akol shilpanipun, orthat dokkhotar karone hoye thake. So I conclude here with this. I know very well that I should not exceed the time limit because today's main attraction is Nivedita Didi. So thank you very much again for giving me the chance to speak a few words. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. It is always a worthy experience for me to listen to you, sir. So thank you very much. And definitely, sir, we will continue this program. And every month there will be the guest lectures and other programs as Principal Sir has mentioned. Thank you very much, sir. So ladies and gentlemen and my dear student friends, today I am really lucky and feeling honored to introduce our honorable resource person with you. She is none other than Padmasri Nivedita Raghunath Vire, the All India Vice President of Vivekananda Kendra Kanyakumari. Nivedita Didi has written over 15 books, presented papers in various national and international seminars, and has given lectures in IITs and various universities, including Kansas University of USA. Her representatives, responsibilities, including training of Jivanbratis of Vivekananda Kendra, training of the teachers of Vivekananda Vidyalaya, and coordinations of Vivekananda Kendra Institute of Culture, Guwahati. Didi has represented India in seminar on Swami Vivekananda conducted by ICCR in 2013 at Melbourne, Australia. May I now request our Honorable Nivedita Didi to please inaugurate the Vivekananda Kendra Center of BN College. Over to you, Didi. Thank you very much. So I seek the blessings from Honorable Nivedita Didi, all honorable dignitaries, well-wishers, and respected participants present today so that we can achieve the aim and objectives of the center. Thank you once again. Now it is a time to listen to our honorable resource person for which all of us are eagerly waiting. So I would like to request Nivedita Didi to kindly start her lecture. Over to you, Didi.
Respected Vibhasda, I am very happy that today he was present and he has given the inaugural address. Respected Principal Shri Dhruva Bhattacharya ji, all the faculty members, students, guests, Kendra Karyakartas, my namaskars to you all. I am extremely happy that today BN College has started Vivekananda Study Center. As we know, many years before, our government of India had declared Swami Vivekananda's birth anniversary as the National Youth Day, because Swamiji's message invigorates the youth, shows them the path. Swami Vivekananda himself was a young man, and he understood the youth very well. So his thoughts really give direction to our life. And that is how this center plans to work among the students, faculties. And I was very happy to notice that not only within the college, but even in the nearby communities. So my all best wishes and prayers that the principal and the faculty members have taken the decision to start this center will be very successful, and it will really help our youth to take our country to the great heights. Now coming to the topic of today, that is education for man making. Though the whole focus of this center will be on man making and nation building, our today's topic is education for man making. So one by one we shall enter into the subject. Now first, when we say man making, so first is, what is man? When we say man, what do we mean? So does man mean only an individual? Is it only body, mind, intellect, complex? So if we see by our own example that man is not only body, mind, intellect, but he is part of the family, the society, the nation, and the whole creation. We know it. For example, suppose something happens to your brother and he is suffering. You know, tears come in your eyes. Though physically nothing has happened to you, but his physical pain brings tears into your eyes. We are connected, or we are part of the family. Same way in the society, if there is no peace, no happiness, even a family cannot live happily. So we are connected, the family is connected to the society. And we are also connected to the nation, because whatever the values, the cultural contents that are there in our life are given by our nation. And as we know, we are also part of this whole existence. That is, for our existence, trees are required, river is required, atmosphere is required, even though small earthworms are required. So if we take it as per what Swami Vivekananda had told, he says, each soul is potentially divine. The goal of life is to manifest that divinity by controlling the nature, external and internal. That means all the great capacities, capabilities, values, qualities are within us. And to manifest that is the aim of life. Now, when we say each soul is potentially divine, it means we are not just body-mind complex, but we are that expanding consciousness which has manifested as the family, as the society, as the nation, and the whole creation. For example, this finger is there. Now the expanded form of the finger is hand, this palm. The expanded form of this palm is the whole hand. The expanded form of the whole hand is the body. So everything is interconnected. Whatever happens to my body, immediately this hand will go to take care of it. If insect is biting or somewhere pain is there, immediately the hand will apply the oil there. And the each unit doesn't have existence in itself. That is, the finger doesn't have existence in itself. If it is disconnected from the palm, this finger is useless. If this palm is disconnected from the hand, the palm is useless. If this hand is disconnected from the body, the hand existence becomes meaningless. So same way, when we say man, that man is consciousness, Atma Chaitana, जो प्रकटित होने वाली आत्मचेतना है, विस्तारित होने वाली आत्मचेतना है. और इसीलिए मनुष्य का ही विस्तारित स्वरूप परिवार है, परिवार का विस्तारित स्वरूप समाज है, समाज का विस्तारित स्वरूप राष्ट्र है, और राष्ट्र का विस्तारित स्वरूप यह पूर्ण विश्व है. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, सपोज ए बॉय इज ग्रोइंग, ए चाइल्ड इज ग्रोइंग, एंड इफ हिज होल बॉडी इज नॉट ग्रोइंग, let us say his only legs are growing, but other body is as it is, then that is not the growth. Same way, our expanded forms are family, society, nation, and the whole creation. Now suppose if only individually I am getting what I want, but my family is not getting that, my society is lagging behind, my nation is progressing, or this environment is getting degraded, then gradually my existence also becomes meaningless. And therefore, when we say man making education, in that man making education comes even the family, the society, even the organization, the institution where I am working, that is also my extended form, and the nation and the whole creation. So when we say man making education, it means the first thing is that education makes man a harmonious part of the family, harmonious part of the society, harmonious part of the nation and the whole creation. That is, my existence, you know, should be a blessing to this environment, because I am living, the environment should not get impoverished, the environment should not get, the nature should not get depleted, but actually it should get enriched. Only then my living life is meaningful, useful. Because of me, my nation should not suffer. Actually, my nation should become more affluent. My nation should become more peaceful. My society should become more peaceful. If that is how my life is, then really it is man-making education that I had, and I have lived like that. And because of me, my family should also come up. So the man-making education, first thing is, it is the individual development, the family happiness, the social well-being, the national regeneration, and the environmental balance protection. All this gets incorporated in man-making education if we understand the real meaning of man. Man is not separated from all this existence. He is interconnected. Today we know even the science, the ecology is talking the same thing. You know, if we are teaching even the class 3 children that tree should not be cut, otherwise our existence will be in danger. So it's not only because our existence will be in danger we should teach that. Actually, they are part of us. Now in quantum physics, those of you who are studying quantum physics, you know that there is nothing like here and there. Everything is interconnected. They say instantaneously one subatomic particle communicates with the other subatomic particles. What the result will be, what the scientist decides accordingly, that subatomic particle will give the result, whether it will be reflection or diffraction or whatever, whether that subatomic particle will behave like a wave or it will behave like a particle. You must have heard about quantum entanglement. So like this, so many things means we can, that itself can become another topic. How quantum physics is telling everything is interconnected, interrelated, interdependent. But one thing I was reading and I liked it very much, in that, you know, because everything is subatomically interconnected, you know, the electrons in our body, as we know, our body is made of cells, cells are made of molecules, then atoms, atoms are made of electrons, electrons are made of still subatomic particles called quarks. Now, all these particles, you know, are joyously, they are wanting to connect with the whole world. They want to love the whole world. They want to accept the whole thing as our own. But we say, no, don't go there. She laughed at you that day. Stop talking to her. No, your brother is not good. That day he humiliated. So he should not stay in your house. No, that man did like that. And this is how the mind keeps on telling. So our body electrons get confused. They want to love the whole world. The mind says, no, 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 don't go here, don't go there. That is not right. This is not right. Condemn that man. Humiliate that person. Hurt him. Throw him out. And because of that, lot of nowadays, why so much stress, strain, and so many psychosomatic diseases come? So that person was telling on the basis of quantum physics, because the physical reality wants to be one with the world, but the mental reality does not allow it. So the at subtler level, we are all interconnected. So this is what we had understood in our culture. And that is why, as Vibhasda told just now, by giving the example of deep learning paper, what all things he mentioned, like character, citizenship, collaboration, communication, creativity, creative thinking, and all that. So in that, if we go deeply, we see this is what was ingrained in man making education. So after seeing what man is, now coming to the understanding of education. You know, if we had to say education is for livelihood also, that is required. That is, after getting education, we should be able to stand on our feet. But education should also be for how to live the life. I may be able to stand on my own feet, I get livelihood. But if I do not know how to live the life, I may be a problem to my wife, I may be a problem to my children, I may be a problem to my colleagues, and ultimately, then we become problem to ourselves. So we have to know how to live the life, how our life has to be meaningful, contributing. So education should have both this aim covered. One is the education for livelihood, and another is education for living life meaningfully. So living life meaningfully, when we say, it has some different connotations. The one is that my life should be, as I mentioned before, it should bring harmony, blessings to all my extended forms. So my extended forms are my family, society, organization, institution, nation, the whole creation. So my existence should bring that blessing. Wherever I go, I must bring that. So this is how I should be welcomed anywhere. I have seen, once I had gone to Andaman, and there is one teacher. He is now part of our committee there. So he is government school teacher. But whenever his transfer is done from one school to other, you know, the principal fights with the administration. No, no, please don't transfer him. Everyone wants him. That is, wherever he goes, he creates such academic and happy atmosphere that he is wanted by all. And so I asked him a question. That how is it like that? How you have become such a sought after personality? You know what he told me? Something very interesting. He told that I had come to Andaman to my uncle's house. And that time I had completed my MSc. So I saw just some advertisement that some teachers were required. So I applied. Now, after applying, I thought I will not get selected. I am such a fresh candidate. But I got selected. And government job got selected. So he could not say no to the job. But he went, kept on saying, I never wanted to be teacher. And you know what to do. So like that, he said, I kept grudging. But I am not ready to leave the job also. But I kept grudging. I never wanted to be teacher, like that. Then one day, one person told me, really, if you don't want, resign now. But don't keep crying your whole life. So decide. Whatever you want to be, make your own choice. So in man-making education, I learned to take, you know, responsibility of my choices. I choose to be this. And he said, that suddenly opened my eyes. Really, am I going to be a crying teacher whole my life? So if I have taken this job, I will become such a teacher that everyone will really cherish me. And really, he became like that. So whatever line we choose in life, it's not what line it is. You may become even life worker of Vivekananda Kendra, or you become a teacher, you become a scientist, whatever you become. Maybe you had thought of becoming something, but you could not become. And therefore, you had to go for some other job. Don't keep crying. In whatever role you are, you should be a contributing person. We know the example of APJ Abdul Kalam. You know, he wanted to become a pilot and he did not get selected. So then he later went into science research, and we know he became a missile man. And he also the president of India, and such a great contribution he has done. So whatever role ultimately we decide, or our destiny brings to us, choose it and leave it with a choice and make a contributing life. So this is what is the first thing when we say that जीवन जीने की कला यानी जो मैं अभी मुझे करना है, जो भूमिका मैंने स्वीकारी है, उस भूमिका को मैं पूरा पूरा न्याय दूंगा। सिर्फ न्याय ही नहीं, उसको आनंद से करूंगा। इसीलिए मैं जहां भी जाऊंगा लोग मेरा स्वागत ही करेंगे। तो ये पहला। दूसरा, the second thing, bring out the best in you. Education is to bring out the best in you. As Swami Vivekananda said, education is the manifestation of the perfection already in man. It's not that we have to go in search of it. It is within us. Only someone may have to strive little bit. Some may have to strive little harder. That's all is the difference. But all of us can manifest the best in us. We have all the great qualities of heart and head within us. And therefore, the education should be such that I manifest best. So, it means the competition is not with others, but it is with myself. How I was yesterday, I should be better than that today. How I was 2 years before, I should be better than that now. And from today, after 2 years, I should be still better than this. So this sort of competing with oneself. Now you are students, you are studying. I will say even in marks also, you compete with yourself. Don't compete with others. So whatever is your mark, you decide what is the next level you want to reach. Or in any developing any qualities. Because each one is unique. Each one of us is unique. If you have studied coordinate geometry, you know each point has its own coordinates, which no other point can have. So similarly, each one of us have our own specific coordinates, which no one have. So we are unique. And that uniqueness we have to manifest by competing with ourselves and not with others. And that is to bring out the best in us. Then similarly, education is to, you know, reach the aim of life or realize the aim of life. What for human life is. And if that we have to see, then human life has two, it is a twofold purpose of human life. One is to know ultimately what we are, you know, means I can give it a very traditional word for that is self-realization, God-realization or whatever. Or to put it in some different language, we can say, or as Maslow has told, reaching the self-expression level, whatever. But ultimately, it is you should be at peace with yourself. Whatever it is, the peace should really reflect on your face, in your words, in your action. So I am at peace with myself and I am contributing to all the, means this is one, that you are rooted in your own inner being. This is first time. And the second purpose of life is that I become a contributing factor to all the collectives. So another purpose of education is, man-making education is, to realize our aim of life. Now, when we are talking this, you know, in our country, this man-making education, we had really achieved to almost 100%. Almost, I am saying, because human nature is always there. There will be always some, exceptions will be there. But we had achieved it. So just to give few examples, you know, people came from all over the world here to learn from us, whether it was from China, whether it was from Indonesia, whether it was from Malaysia, whether it was from Thailand, whether it was from, you know, Russia or many other countries. The people came here to learn. even today they come to learn, but they come to learn maybe yoga, ayurveda, or our adhyatma, that is spirituality, they come. But in those days, all the subjects, they came to learn here. So this is what is the first thing. The second example, in each field, if you see, India has contributed immensely, whether it is culture, whether it is grammar, whether it is language development, whether it is architecture, whether it is paintings, whether it is textiles, whether it is mathematics, physics, chemistry, you take any field of human life, and India had contributed immensely. Why? Because that was the education. Whatever I do, I will do it to the best of my ability. मैं जो भी काम करूंगी मेरे अंदर की सारी अच्छाई को प्रकटित करते हुए करूंगी. तो इसीलिए हम काम चुपकार कभी थे नहीं. हमने ऐसे ही ऊपर ऊपर काम करके छोड़ दिया, ऐसा हमारा कभी स्वभाव नहीं था. और इसीलिए इन ईच फील्ड वी कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटेड इमेंसली. टूडे ऑल्सो यू कैन ऑलवेज इन इंटरनेट फाइंड आउट. अनदर थिंग फॉर एग्जाम्पल आई विल गिव यू, यू नो आरसी मुजुमदार हैज रिटन हिस्ट्री ऑफ इंडिया. भारतीय विद्या भवन हैड ब्रॉट आउट some 12 volumes are there, very big volumes, and in that volume he has written when in 17th-18th century foreign travelers from west started coming to India, you know, they have described India in many ways. First thing is they described the science and technology of India, that is the manufacturing of steel was a cottage industry in our country, and they say with less cost, less money, less time, but better quality of steel was manufactured in India. And then they even drew the picture of furnace and all, and then they sent the papers from here. So in different fields, how India was advanced, that is in 18th century papers, these are published, these are online available. Any one of you who are interested, you can put it, the science and technology in 18th century in India by Dharampal. Dharampal has only collected these papers written by the foreign travelers. Dharampal, or even if you write Dharampal's complete works, you will get that. And it is in many languages also. So this is one example. That is science and technology, not in ancient time, but up to 18th century. This is what is the first thing. Then second thing, you know, the way the women were so secure in our land, this is what Vibhas Da was referring to as character making education. You know, one Abbe Dubois, one Christian missionary from France, he writes, if in India a woman walks on the road, she doesn't have to face any bad comment or bad eye of any passerby. Everyone will respect. Here women are very highly respected, another person writes. So different persons he has quoted that how the women were completely secure and they could walk and they were very highly regarded. That is also one mark of advancement of culture as well as character, that is man-making education. That how a woman is safe and she is respected very highly. Like that, we can go on quoting many things, but I don't want to go about the achievements of that. Coming to the one more point, that this we all should know, because this is very important. That when we talk of man-making education, we feel, oh, maybe India had that education in ancient period. That is, Gurukul were there and children used to stay there. But Gurukul is not the only thing. Actually, again, this Dharampal's one book is there, Beautiful Tree. In that beautiful tree, he has given the details. It so happened in 1931, when Mahatma Gandhi had gone to London for a roundtable conference, Mahatma Gandhi said that the beautiful tree of education in my country is cut down by you British and therefore today we are far more illiterate than we were 100 years before. When Gandhiji said that, you know, one Philip Hertog, he stood, one parliamentarian, he said, "No, Mr. Gandhi, you are wrong. It is we British who have educated the masses of India." Gandhiji said, "No." And then Gandhiji said, "I will prove it." Philip Hertog said, "You prove, otherwise you have to apologize." Gandhiji said, "I will prove it." And then Philip Hertog himself wrote a book proving how British had actually improved the educational status of Indians. But what he did actually was, he took from 1901, that is, it was a British period, even before that was a British period, and he compared it with 1930. So that there was not much meaning in his presentation. What Gandhiji was telling was 100 years before. So Dharampal thought that if Dharampal is a great Gandhian, so now he is no more, few years before only he passed away. He thought if Gandhiji had said so convincingly, so there must be some truth in it. So he went to London and he went through all the declassified records of the British period in India. And there he stumbled upon an educational survey which was conducted in 1823. It means beginning of the 19th century. 1823, this educational survey was conducted by the British, and it was conducted by the British collectors for each district, and it was compiled by one Christian missionary, William Adams. And William Adams himself is so shocked. He says, in India, every village has a school. If village is little bigger, then it has more schools. And of course, the towns have many more schools. He says, there is no village in India without a school. And then some British collectors, for example, the Bellary district British collector and all, they were very thorough in conducting this survey. So they give the list of books which the children have to study in their primary education. Primary education was almost 5 to 7 years. And everyone went for primary education. After that, the students went either in father's business or they went for higher education. So colleges were also there. I will not tell you the whole story, though it's a very interesting story. My point is that list of books which collector has given, we have to read that. In that there are such books which will really mold the character. Ramayan is there, Mahabharat is there, Tattva Bodh is there, and you know, Vidur Niti Shatakam is there, then Bhartruhari Niti Shatakam is there, and like that it goes on. Some 23 books to be studied the first 7 years of or 5 years of your schooling. So today, if we see, our education does not give us this character molding education. And therefore, if we come today, we see that we are getting good education, no doubt, but that education is mainly for the livelihood. And therefore, the colleges like, I will say BN College, had to come forward, you know, to supplement what, as such, the formal school curriculum or college curriculum is there, to supplement it so that the character molding education, the man making education, gets given to us. And that is why, as I told in the beginning also, I am telling again also, that VN College really needs to be congratulated by all of us for taking this lead. Because today, our study curriculum, it is not focusing on these, that is the objectives of life or the aim of life, or I am part of all these collectives and therefore I must contribute to the well-being of family, society, nation and the whole creation. But whereas we are taught success means it's only individual success, that I have to contribute, this thought is very rarely given. Or you have to bring out the best in you. So whatever work you do, it should be to the best of your ability. You know, manifestation of the excellence by controlling the nature, external and internal. So this controlling of the nature, external and internal, means self-control. That self-control also today is not part of either education in school or colleges or even in many homes. I will just give you one example of home. Our children, suppose their school is in the morning, then they have to get up in the morning at 6 o'clock, get ready, go to school. Okay. Now, suppose if Sunday is there, the parents tell, beta, aaj so jao, aaj Sunday hai. Aaj tumne nahi utne se bhi chalega. Abhi hum kya kar rahe hai? Hame to bacche ko aadat lagani hai na, ki ek nitya routine hona hai. There has to be a daily routine. You know, the body and mind have nature to go down. So they are to be always tightened in a pakka routine. And then only the inner strength, atma shakti tabhi pravahit hoti hai. Then only the inner strength gets manifested. But if you put your body and mind in all the indulgences, then the inner strength does not get manifested. But this is what is happening. Parents tell, beta so jao, aaj Sunday hi hai. तो बेटे को लगता है इसका मतलब स्कूल यानी क्या है, पनिशमेंट है. स्कूल जाना है यानी और सवेरे उठना पड़ता है. तो हमने ऐसा यानी बेटा शिक्षा यानी तुम्हारा जीवन ऐसा होना है कि तुम्हारा एक एक क्षण का तुमने योग्य उपयोग करना सीखना है. व्हाट इज आफ्टर ऑल लाइफ, लाइफ इज टाइम एंड एनर्जी. सो इफ रियली आई वॉन्ट टू मेक माई लाइफ, आई हैव टू लर्न हाउ टू मेक यूज ऑफ माई टाइम एंड एनर्जी purposefully. So what is the purpose of life? How do I spend my time and energy in that? But we only tell children, ha, aaj Sunday hai na, aaj tum tablet pe khel sakte ho, ek ghanta khel sakte ho, aaj main tumko tablet dungi. Aisa karte hue khane ki bhi cheeze, we all know, I am deliberately focusing on the education at home. Because education is not only in the formal educational institutions like school and colleges, but also from home, a child is educated. But even there, we see it is not being done very meaningfully. So a child, you know, he gives permission to mother, I want in my tiffin, what I carry, lunch box, you know, I don't want this rice and roti and all. You must give me pizza or you must give me noodles. And mother also tells, oh, my child likes this, so I give. Otherwise, you know, he will not eat. So we are giving junk food. And what is the result? The child is at the age of 30, he gets diabetes. At the age of 35, he gets blood pressure. At the age of 40, there are heart attacks. Why 40? Recently, I got 2-3 examples where a 24-year-old boy died of heart attack. Can you imagine? Means when we should live our life very meaningfully, you know, contributing very nicely. That time there are so many restrictions on the body. You cannot eat this, you cannot sit for 2 hours continuously because your back aches, you know, you have spondylitis and all this. So man-making education also has, you know, strong body and very strong mind. Dharana shakti wala man chahiye. कि मैंने यदि तय किया है मैं एक घंटा पढ़ाई करूंगा तो एक घंटा मन पढ़ाई करेगा, मन इधर उधर जाएगा ही नहीं. ऐसा मन का स्थैर्य, ऐसा हमें प्राप्त करना है. लेकिन ऐसा भी ना मन का प्रशिक्षण होता है, ना शरीर का प्रशिक्षण होता है, ना बुद्धि का प्रशिक्षण होता है. आई विल टेल यू, आई यूज टू कंडक्ट इंटरव्यूज ऑफ मेनी ग्रेजुएट्स, पोस्ट ग्रेजुएट्स फॉर वर्किंग एज टीचर्स इन अवर स्कूल्स. सो candidate will come in front of me. I used to ask, okay, you are MA in English. So tell me, what is the book of English literature you have read in last 6 months? Then he says, no, madam, I have not read anything. He will only tell the names which were there for his course. Apart from that, have you read at least 5 books? If I ask, the answer is no. Okay, I ask him, tell me, which is the longest poem in English? Who has written the longest poem? He is in MA English literature, but he does not know that it is an Indian, that is Sri Aurobindo had written Savitri, which is even today the longest poem and a philosophical poem, a mystic poem at that, in English. But we do not know. Okay, he is MA history or BA history. I ask him, you tell me what is the most significant historical incident in 20th century for India? You know, question is very simple. I am not testing his historical knowledge from the book. I am asking him, tell me which is the most significant historical incident for India in 20th century. You know, the answer is, madam, I did my BA now 3 years before. Now I don't remember anything. But if I have to teach, I can teach. Then I ask him, do you know when India got freedom? Is it not the most significant historical incident for India? For that, do you have to remember it? So what is it we are learning? Means even we study, but we don't remember anything. There is no application. So if I study MA English literature, I must develop the test for English literature. But I have not read any English book. means I can go on telling you because there are so many experiences when I interviewed these people. Actually, I used to get depressed. That what is it we are studying? Only for exam we are studying. It is not sharpening of the intellect. It is not, you know, the capacity to retain. I have seen a person in Kerala. He is even now there. You know, he knows Ashtanga Hrudayam by heart. Ashtanga Hrudayam has 120 chapters. Then he is a doctor, Ayurveda doctor. Then Charaka Sanhita by heart. Then he has Ashtanga Sangraha by heart. Bhagavad Gita by heart, Raghuvamsha by heart, Kumara Sambhavam by heart, Upanishad, at least few Upanishads by heart. I asked him, how do you know all this? He said, I had made a rule every day to study one shloka by heart. And you know, he doesn't have to refer any book. He just listens to the patient and he will go on different, all shlokas he can narrate and cross-check, and ultimately he comes to the diagnosis and gives the medicine, and he is a very good doctor. So, and he tells that he studied first, you know, in a traditional school where he was made to learn by heart and all. So people used to make fun of him, but today, you know, his knowledge is so immense. So what I am trying to tell is, it's fine. Our today's education exposes us to many subjects. It gives us many ways because of technology also, you know, to find out different topics. So what is good in today's education? Very good. We should take it. But that is not enough. That is not adequate to make our life. It is not man-making education. And that is why we need supplement efforts. So that is why we need Vivekananda Study Center. We need Vivekananda Kendra. We need different youth camps, you know, for youth to come and get associated and develop themselves. So when we are talking of man-making education, if today my college curriculum, school curriculum does not give me man-making education, then there are two, three things. One, I must have self-efforts. That is, I will decide my own plan, how I develop myself. So, as I told you, daily routine, you know, it is for character making. So your body and mind should be completely trained in a tight routine. Don't allow just to waste the time and then tell, I have no time. In WhatsApp, our time goes so much. In YouTube, our time goes so much. We cannot say we have no time. Actually, our today's youth have more problems because they have so many distractions. And therefore, they need better self-control. Better training of mind. So this is one thing. That is, we have to train ourselves. Training ourselves means few things. One is a strong body. So for strong body, proper exercise, proper diet, and in today's situation, very important is proper rest. Because of that small devil in our hand, that is mobile. You know, we keep on sitting late at night, and because we sit late at night, then we cannot get up early in the morning. Then our whole routine is here and there, and everything goes. Then I tell, okay, tomorrow I will surely do it. Again, night, that day will divorce us, and again the whole day is gone. So make your own pakka rule. After 9, I don't touch mobile. and I will read something and go to sleep. You know, unless we are strict with ourselves in today's world, no one is going to mold us. So if really I am serious about my life, if really I want a life, a contributing life, a satisfying life, a life which is blessing to all, then I have to train myself. So for body, food, exercise, rest. Then for mind also, proper training needs to be given. So for that also, Vivekananda Kendra also conducts camp, how we should take sankalpa, how we should train our mind, हमारी धारणा शक्ति कैसे बढ़नी है. तो दिस इज ऑल्सो अनदर ट्रेनिंग. बुद्धि ऑल्सो ट्रेनिंग नीड्स टू बी गिवन. नाउ सो वन इज सेल्फ एफर्ट्स. द सेकंड इज यू नो यू आर फॉर्चुनेट इफ यू गेट ए गुड कॉलेज वेयर सच वेरियस प्रोग्राम्स आर कंडक्टेड. लाइक यू नो नाउ फॉर एग्जाम्पल Vivekananda study center is there. Oh, a study center is there. It's all right. What is to go? Okay, certificate I will get. Okay, then I will attend some 2-3 programs. Somehow I will manage for certificate I will go. Please don't do like that. Don't make use of Vivekananda study center only to get some marks added to your total marks. Please use it as something you want to really make your life. And therefore, go to it, be very active in that, participate very well. Only then, and Swami Vivekananda is like that. You know, Roma Rola had told, if you are lying down and reading Swami Vivekananda, you will sit. If you are sitting and reading Vivekananda, you will stand. If you are standing and reading Vivekananda, you will start walking. It means what? Swami Vivekananda takes us to the next orbit of movement and development. Please understand this. Swami Vivekananda's thoughts take us to the next orbit of development. So if you really want to mold yourself, make a very sincere use of Vivekananda study center and its activities. So this is second thing. Means if we are fortunate, we have a college where such activities are there, we become a willing, a sincere participant of those activities. And third is, we can go in search of such organizations which again help us, like Vivekananda Kendra, as I told you. So I think time is also up. And so with this, man making education is responsibility of all. But if unfortunately today our education is exam oriented, is only for certificate oriented, then we have to mold ourselves if I really want to live a meaningful life. So with this, I conclude. Thank you.
So thank you very much, Didi. I was actually mesmerized of listening and I did not look to the clock also, what is the timings. And so Didi, if you allow, can we, there be an interaction session and can we take some queries or discussion?
Okay.
Okay, so dear participants, so if you have any query, you can write in the chat box, or you can, if you can raise your hand, I request Bappa, our technical person, to please unmute that person and allow him or her to ask the questions, or you can write also. But Didi, I have a query. It's not a query actually. Just I want to learn, because I am a teacher and my responsibility to teach my students, to help them in the life. But I think as a teacher, I have to learn a lot, that so many things actually, though I teach chemistry, then how to give the life skill in that particular time frame, 1 hour, 2 hour classes. Just few tips, Didi, if you share with us, because lots of teachers are here.
Okay. I will say the first and foremost is, you know, which you have, but because you ask me, I'm just listing out the genuine concern and love for our students. So genuine love and concern for our students. Then with that, we have to develop a good rapport with them. So it is beyond my role as a teacher. You know, I become genuinely interested in their development. So for that, sometimes I just chit chat with them, or I meet them in the corridor. Also, I meet them, I talk to them. So this is one thing: the genuine concern and love, and building a rapport with them. Then third is, even in our session when we are teaching, you know, there are certain things which we can really correlate with character development, and such topics we should find out how I can correlate. We have to just mention, just while teaching them, mention just one or two sentences. Actually, this just passing references itself will make very deep impact on them when you are teaching it. If you also remember, you had such teachers, you will remember these interaction with you. So this is second thing which we can do in our own syllabus. For example, as I was telling you about quantum physics, so I am teaching about quantum entanglement, or I am teaching about this, then I had to tell this, that we are all connected. So are we really working for our family, society, nation? You know, we should become their harmonious part. Just a 2-3 sentences we mention and we go back to our syllabus. So where all can I give such inputs? That we have to see. Third thing, as you know, Swami Vivekananda's one professor was there, Professor Hastie. So he had told, if you want to know what is Bhava Samadhi, you go and see Sri Ramakrishna. That is, we can become a person who guide them to a proper place, or a proper person where they can go, or proper activity where they can participate. And if we ourselves are participating in such activities, then more than that, they get inspired that, oh, our teacher is there, I will also go. Once I had gone to one very reputed institution, in that the director himself was involved in such activity, you know, about man making or character molding activities. And students also were there, faculties also were there. So when I was sitting with them, I asked one student, why did you join this? He said, first, I didn't have any much attraction for this character and all that, but I thought if I join this, you know, even our director comes in this study group. So if I join, I can even see director from close quarters. I can see my faculty members from close quarters. So I thought I must join. But after joining, I found that even this is very useful. So like that. Means we ourselves should participate in such activities, and we can direct the students also to such activities.
Yes, yes. Actually, teacher should be a 24-hour teacher, in the classroom itself. Yes. Thank you, Didi. Now, Didi, one Nayanjati Bora has written that how to excel in academic life.
Yes. Actually, even for teacher to become a very effective teacher, their academic also should be very good. Teaching also should be very good. That point I forgot to tell. Now he has asked how to be excellent in academic life. I will tell you one thing. There is no substitute, you know, for hard work. A genius is 10% genius and 90% hard work. So if we think at the exam time I can manage, then you will only manage. But if you really want to excel in academic life, then first thing, whatever lessons are taught today, you try to read it on that day itself. But I used to do something different. So I will tell you what I used to do.
Didi, please go unmute, Didi. Yes, thank you.
So what I used to do, I used to read a lesson which teacher is going to take next time. Means before itself, first I will learn. I will study, I will read. So that helped me in a way to understand things on my own. And if I don't understand anything, when teacher is teaching, I could ask the questions and get the knowledge. As it is said, no, that Shraddhaya Pranipatena Pariprashnena Sevaya. How the knowledge is acquired, Shraddhaya, with Shraddha. Pranipatena, by humility. Then Pariprashnena, we should know how to ask questions and get certain areas clear. So that interest in subject should be there. And then Sevaya, that is by being, by by actually serving such great persons. So this is how in Bhagavad Gita it is said. But for academic also, you have to study first on your own. Then when teacher is teaching, try to ask more questions. And nowadays, you know, that same devil can be also very useful if we want to, you know, how to make devil work for us, we have to learn. So even we can find out many more things about that subject. And first develop the genuine interest to know the subject. Means the purpose should not be to get good marks. The first purpose should be to acquire knowledge. And then when exam comes, from exam point of view, you can study. But if you have acquired knowledge in the subject, then to prepare from exam point of view is always easier. So you can very well do it.
Yes, I think he is satisfied. Didi, one Bishwajit Ghosh has written that he says, Didi Pranam, then Bhaktitva Nirman ke jariye Bharat ko kaise feet se Vishwaguru Ashan pe bitha sakte hai?
मैं उसमें बहुत ज्यादा गई नहीं, यानी गहराई में गई नहीं. मैंने सिर्फ इतना ही बताया कि हम राष्ट्र पुनरुत्थान में भी हमारा योगदान करना है. तो एक तो मैन मेकिंग एजुकेशन में जब ये बताया जाता है कि आई एम पार्ट ऑफ ऑल दिस कलेक्टिव्स, तो मैं राष्ट्र का भी अंग हूँ, तो राष्ट्र के प्रति भी मेरा कर्तव्य है, ये एक बात समझना. दूसरा, राष्ट्र बोध होना, यानी राष्ट्र, यानी जैसे हम पॉलिटिकल पार्टी कोई रूल कर रही है, यानी पॉलिटिकल इंडिया, ऐसा भारत को मत समझिए. जैसे इसके लिए एक बहुत अच्छा आर्टिकल है, आप इंटरनेट में डालने से भी आपको मिल सकता है, रविंद्रनाथ टैगोर का हिस्ट्री ऑफ भारत वर्ष, आप उसको जरूर पढ़िए. वो पहले बंगाली में लिखा था, लेकिन इसका इंग्लिश ट्रांसलेशन है हिस्ट्री ऑफ भारत वर्ष. सो ही सेज भारत का इतिहास, यानी ये राजा आया, उसने ऐसा आक्रमण किया, फिर ऐसा राज्य किया, ये भारत का इतिहास नहीं है. भारत क्या है? तो इतने सारे आक्रमणों के, तूफानों के बावजूद भी इस राष्ट्र में जो सर्वसाधारण लोग है वो विविधता में एकात्मता को कैसे ढूंढते रहे, प्राप्त करते रहे और विविधता को स्वीकारते रहे, ये भारत की विशेषता है, टू सी वन इन मेनी. तो ऐसा जो एक भारत को समझना है, उसका भी प्रयास हमने करना है. तो मैन मेकिंग एजुकेशन में, बिकॉज आई एम पार्ट ऑफ द नेशन, आई हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड नेशन, मुझे राष्ट्र समझना है. मैं फिर से पॉलिटिकल भारत की बात नहीं कर रही हूँ, तो राष्ट्र समझना है. एक बार वो राष्ट्र समझ गया, जो गांव गांव में है, जो घरों घरों में है, वो हमें भारत समझता है, फिर उसके लिए कार्य करना, जो मैंने पहले ही बताया कि हमारे जीवन का उद्दिष्ट क्या है, एक अपने आत्मा में स्थित होना, आत्मस्थ होना, आत्म साक्षात्कार करना, जो भी नाम देना है, और दूसरा कि मेरा जीवन ये इन सारे समष्टि को कंट्रीब्यूट करने वाला होना है, यानी परिवार को भी होना है, समाज को भी होना है, राष्ट्र को भी होना है. तो ऐसा होगा तो भारत के बारे में ज्यादा जानेंगे. और अभी विवेकानंद स्टडी सेंटर में स्वामी जी के जो लेक्चर्स है ना, फ्रॉम कोलंबो टू अल्मोरा, वेरी ब्यूटीफुल लेक्चर्स, तो वो भी जरूर पढ़ने से भारत समझता है. समझने से प्रेम उत्पन्न होता है, प्रेम उत्पन्न होने से त्याग करने की सहज वृत्ति होती है और कार्य करने की भी वृत्ति होती है. और फिर जो क्षेत्र, जो शुरू में मैंने बताया, जो क्षेत्र हमने चुना है उसमें बेस्ट कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन करना, वॉट एवर आई कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट टू द बेस्ट ऑफ माई एबिलिटी, यानी जो भी काम करना है, काम चुकार नहीं होना कभी. ऐसा हर कोई अपना काम अच्छा से करते हैं तो बहुत अच्छा योगदान हम कर सकते हैं.
Yes, yes, Didi. Didi, another question from Mala Roy Talukdar. Can you explain the difference between an academic scholar and an intellectual thinker?
Academic scholar, I will say, in a way, you know, they go by certain discipline. Okay, that's why we call different branches also discipline. So suppose I will give you one example. Anthropology is one subject. Okay, now you are trained in anthropology, so you have developed certain way of looking at things. It's a certain discipline, it has certain rules and rules and regulations is not the exact word, but certain norms to study a subject. But actually, if we go into the root of anthropology subject, the anthropology subject itself was created by the conquerors to study the conquered societies. That is, their basic premises was that apart from the Western countries, all other country communities are a specimen to be studied, you know, and therefore looking down upon them, the study was taken up. That is how anthropological study started, and it was done. And therefore, its whole discipline is that way. Why I am telling you, in Guwahati, Vivekananda Kendra has Vivekananda Kendra Institute of Culture, where we undertake the studies of culture and traditions of various communities. So first, when we started this study through the academic scholarship of anthropology, you know, we were getting not the results that we wanted. That is the real, what are those principles, values, which has made the community survive through all these vicissitudes or troubles or invasions, and how the community has adjusted itself to the changes. All these things we will not get. We will only get, suppose, that whether child marriage is there and whether adultery is there. If adultery is there, what punishments are there, whether divination is there, and some such thing only, because that is how anthropology trains you. So academic scholarship is good. In every subject it may be good, but many times, in a way, it develops certain academic specs for us to look at the subject. And intellectual thinker, in a way, does not have the restrictions of the discipline of the academic subject, but he may lack the training of academic scholarship. So if really we want to do something, we must have the training of the academician, and we must also have the originality of the intellectual thinker. If we combine this, then we can really learn things in proper perspective.
Yes. Thank you, Didi. I think I'm not getting any more questions here. But dear participants, if you have any query, you can ask to Didi. And participant friends, the feedback link is given because we want your feedback. We are ready to organize such type of programs. So we want your feedback. So please give your feedback. So if there is no more questions, then we can go to the next part, I think. Okay. So we are almost at the end of the program. So on behalf of IQAC BN College, I offer my sincere thanks and regards to Honorable Vibhas sir for his support and guidance to conceptualize this program. Actually, sir is behind to this program. And I offer my sincere thanks and pranam from the core of my heart to Honorable Nivedita Didi to accept our invitation. I know he remained very busy all the time. Thank you very much, Didi. I am thankful to Honorable Praveen Dhavalkar ji sir for his help, without which it would not be possible for us to organize this program. So thank you, sir. And I offer my thanks to all the Karikarta and office bearers of Vivekananda Kendra, Kanyakumari, Assam Pran for their cooperation. And I'm thankful to our Honorable Principal sir for allowing us and encouraging us to organize this type of program. I'm thankful to all the faculty members and student friends of our college and all the other colleges and universities for their participation. Thank you very much. I'm thankful to all the participants of different institutions for their interest in this program. Thanks are also due to JIT Tech for technical support. And lastly, offer my thanks to all the members of IQC team of our college for their cooperation. So let us conclude this program with Shanti Mantra, so that the peace and tranquility persist in our universe. So I again request Dr. Moshmi Bhattacharji to recite the mantra. Dr. Moshmi, please unmute yourself. Dr. Moshmi, please unmute yourself.
Respected Nivedita Didi, all the dignitaries joined in this webinar, venerable teachers, and my dear students, let us wrap up today's webinar by chanting a Shanti Mantra. Let everyone be happy and let peace prevail in this world. Sarve sukhino bhavantu, sarve santu niramayaha, sarve bhadrani pashyantu, ma kashchit dukkha bhak bhave. Om shanti shanti shanti. Dhanyavaad.
Thank you. Dhanyavaad didi, dhanyavaad sir.
Namaste didi.
So let us conclude here, but we want your blessings all the time, didi, so thank you very much.
Yes, it's always there.